I Love Lucy friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is KJ Ricardo. Today's episode is a guest star spotlight on Elvia Allman. I like to do guest star spotlights every now and then on individuals who appeared multiple times on I Love Lucy. Elvia is definitely one of those. You're probably wondering, who is she? Well, you know her. She's in the Candy Factory episode. She's very famous for this episode, but she also appeared in two other episodes on I Love Lucy. So we're going to talk about her, her career, her biography, and really discuss who she was so you can learn more about her. So let's get started. Elvia was born on September 19th, 1904 in Enochville, North Carolina, and she passed away on March 6th, 1992. She began her career, like others, in the radio industry in the late 1920s. She worked for a program in Los Angeles. She worked as a program arranger and a children's story reader. She later began singing and was praised for her ability to perform in multiple dialects. It was during this time when she met her first husband, Wesley B. Tortelletti. He was a musician for the radio station, and it just seemed to work for them. They got married in 1930, but divorced in 1933. After the divorce, Elvia decided to move to New York and start a new career in radio. She had a regular program that ran until 1935. Elvia continued working in the radio industry throughout the 30s, eventually appearing with Bob Hope. This wouldn't be the first time where she worked with Bob Hope. She would work with him later on. Her voice career transferred over to animated film, and she appeared in multiple cartoons for Warner Brothers. She was in the first Porky Pig cartoon in 1935, and for Disney, she originated the character of Clarabelle the cow in many Disney cartoons in the 30s and 40s, which I think is pretty interesting. She was also a regular on the popular radio program The Abbott and Costello Show, so a very iconic radio program. But like many actors during this time period, she eventually moved from radio to film in the 1940s. The majority of her roles were uncredited, like her first appearance with Bob Hope in The Road to Singapore. It's uncredited. But her most well-known roles were in The Nutty Professor, as well as The Librarian in Breakfast at Tiffany's. Elvia had a variety of roles in radio and film, often playing a shrewish woman, but she would probably be best remembered for her guest star spots in TV shows in the 50s and 60s. She appeared in a variety of shows, including I Married Joan, as well as the George Burns and Gracie Allen show. She appeared on that multiple times, as well as Blondie, the Bob Cummins show, the Jack Benny program, the Dick Van Dyke show, The Lucy Show, appearing with Lucille Ball, The Beverly Hillbillies as Elverna Bradshaw, as well as Petticoat Junction as Selma Plout. She was on that show multiple times. But for this video, we're going to be looking at the episodes in which she appeared on I Love Lucy. So let's look at those in detail. The first episode we're going to be studying is Fan Magazine Interview. This is a great episode. The episode begins with Lucy and Ricky being observed by this reporter who's trying to see what the Ricardos really live, how they really live. So they try to be like the perfect couple. Earlier that day, Ricky's manager told him that he sent out all of these invitations to women to come to the Tropicana for a special night, dinner, dancing, from Ricky. Now, Lucy finds this letter, and the reporter kind of put it into Lucy's mind that maybe Ricky isn't faithful. Maybe he is having an affair. And she finds this invitation to Minnie Finch. So Lucy and Ethel go to Minnie Finch's apartment, and her neighbor is Elvia Allman. One of the great moments is when Elvia pounds on the door and says, "Well, you want to see Minnie? Well, you got to knock. You got to knock if you want to hear her." And she knocks on the door really loud and shouts it. And it's a great moment, a very hilarious moment featuring Elvia. And this is a great episode overall. The next episode is Homecoming. This is when the Ricardos and the Mertzes have returned from Hollywood after Ricky's movie had finished production. So they're back in New York, and it's a grand homecoming. Everyone is treating Ricky like he's a star and treating him differently than they did before they went to Hollywood. Lucy is being interviewed by Nancy Graham, this newspaper woman. And Lucy thinks that this woman is interviewing her about Lucy's life. And so she starts telling her about her life, but the woman only wants to know about Ricky and how Lucy is going to treat Ricky differently. And basically says, "How was it like being married to him?" So you could really tell that she has a crush on Ricky Ricardo as well. And she basically tells Lucy that she needs to be a slave to Ricky. And it's a pretty hilarious moment. And Elvia is really great in this episode. And it starts the rest of the episode with Lucy thinking she has to be a slave to Ricky. While those two episodes were great, we know Elvia Allman from this episode, Job Switching. She plays the candy factory foreman. She's in charge of Lucy and Ethel while they're in training for this job. She's a very strict foreman. I would not want to work for her. She doesn't have a sense of humor. She wants to keep everything in order, but it's just so great. She is very iconic. You know her from this episode. She says the very classic line, "Speed it up a little," which I have a clip of this very iconic scene.
"Now, the candy will pass by on this conveyor belt and continue into the next room where the girls will pack it. Now, your job is to take each piece of candy and wrap it in one of these papers and then put it back on the belt. You understand?"
"Yes, sir."
"Yes, ma'am."
"Let her roll!" "Let her roll!" "Well, wait here. Somebody's asleep at the switch." "All right, girls. Now, this is your last chance. If one piece of candy gets past you and into the packing room unwrapped, you're fired."
"Yes, ma'am."
"Let her roll!"
Elvia's career kind of slowed down in the 1970s. she decided to become a real estate agent. Fun fact, she actually helped Mary Tyler Moore buy her house, which is kind of cool to think about. But then she got back into TV guest spots in the 80s, and her final appearance was a full circle, and she played Clarabelle Cow for Disney after 50 years of being Clarabelle Cow. She appeared in the Mickey Mouse version of The Prince and the Pauper. So, looking into her personal life a little bit, I already mentioned her first husband to Wesley Tortoletti, who she divorced in 1933, but they had one child together. She also married a sports promoter, C.C. Pyle, in 1937, and she was married to him until his death in 1939. And then she met Jerome Baylor in 1945 and was married to him for 33 years until his death in 1978. Elvia passed away on March 6, 1992 in Santa Monica, California from pneumonia, and she was 87 years old. Now, she is best remembered for her radio career, being the original Clarabelle Cow, her roles in many TV shows like Petticoat Junction. But to us personally, the Lucy fans, she will always be the Candy Factory woman who shouted, "Speed it up a little." She will always be that woman for us. And that's it. That's all I have for you this week. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you learned something about the Candy Factory woman. Now you know a little bit more about her and her biography and how she had a fantastic career. Let me know what you learned in this week's episode, and I'll be happy to read that. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time with another video. I'm taking a week off. I'm going on vacation, so there won't be a Lucy video next week, but I will be returning very soon. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. And remember to always laugh often.